Последний аргумент, который будет немаловажный в списке того уже, что я сказал, это то, что все колеи, опять-таки, деформированы. Характер их деформации точно такой же, как неогеновые поверхности выравнивания, на которой они находятся.
The last important argument which testifies about the ancient age of stone rats is their deformation. All rats are deformed. The nature of their deformation is exactly the same as that of the Neogene planation plane or surface on which they are located. If we see a strong erosion of the planation plane, the development of crust of secondary minerals on it, then the same thing happens with the rats. We see rats strongly smoothed by erosion and covered with crust of secondary minerals. If we see that the planation plane is broken by folds through which mineralization takes place with the formation of calcite and quartz, these folds intersect the rats. In addition, in a number of places in Turkey, Spain, Italy, I observed how rats are displaced by folds. These folds lower individual sections of the rats by half a meter or more. As a result, we see how the rats abruptly break off and quaternary sediments are stuck to them. I saw many such places. And if only this, my friend researcher from Germany, Uwe Schneider, sent me fantastic photos from his expedition to Malta in 2016. Another my friend researcher, Silvia Ivanova from Austria, showed the same thing on a video in the expedition to Malta in December 2016. Rats there are situated on the surface of limestone plateaus, cuestas. They approach the edge of the plateau and are cut off by a cliff that has a height of several tens of meters. Consequently, the folds that formed the Table Mountains and the Table Mountains themselves were formed after the wheeled vehicles left the rats. Scientists believe that these folds were formed 16 to 15 million years ago, closer to 15. It turns out that by combination of features, the age of most roads and rats is closer to 15 million years than to 7 or 5 million years. I wrote about this in my work on the rats of the Crimea based on an analysis of the geology of the Crimean Peninsula. Most of the rats apparently formed 15, 14, 17 million years ago. It was then there were highly developed civilizations in the Mediterranean region.
Образовывал эти колеи, он образовался после, эти квесты, эти столовые гроды, он образовался после того, как существовали колеи. Образовались эти разломы, как считается, порядка 15-14 миллионов лет назад, но ближе к 15. То есть вот даже получается по совокупности признаков, и об этом, кстати, я писал, когда изучал, писал работу по Крыму, по колеям Крыма, когда анализировал геологию Крымского полуострова, геологическое строение.
One of the important moments that we will talk about it in more detail in the following films are the footprints of people and animals that accompany some rats. Supporters of classical archaeology, as a rule, say that loaded carts which were pulled by horses formed the rats. However, the vast majority of rats have no footprints between the rats. At the same time, in Bucarest and Castello de Meca in Spain, we managed to find sections of stone rats where footprints remained between the two rats. I showed these prints to my familiar paleontologists from Moscow State University, and they determined that it was most likely the footprints of Miocene camels. Then I picked up the geological literature, and indeed, it turned out that in the area where we found out rats with footprints, Spanish paleontologists found a large number of footprints of Miocene camels Parachaem lichtenjumeliensis, which died out about 6 million years ago.
Нам удалось найти фрагменты колей. Между двумя колеями находились где следы. Я показывал эти следы палеонтологам, моим знакомым, из Московского государственного университета, вот, и определили, что это, скорее всего, следы миоценовых верблюдов. Даже примерно сказали вид. И затем я поднял литературу, и оказалось, что действительно в том районе, где мы обнаружили эти колеи, где обнаружили эти следы, там испанские палеонтологи определили большое количество миоценовых верблюдов, которые вымерли порядка 7 миллионов лет назад.
Besides, there were found footprints of Miocene antelopes. That is not at all. In Castello de Meca in Spain, my partners in the expedition Alexander Zhikharov and Irina Vanaga found remarkable footprints of a three-toed foot 43-44 in size with the dynamics of a step as at a modern man. Barefooted three-fingered foot, who he could be? A man? Not a man. Or some mythical creature. I saw some similar footprints in the rock towns of Espera, Esperilla in the province of Andalusia in Spain. There, however, there was no rats. However, these were the same middle upper Miocene sediments. My partner from Germany, Uwe Schneider, sent even more fantastic photos of footprints from Miocene limestones of Malta, which were found next to the rats. These are prints of human feet in sandals or some kind of shoes. The age of limestones in which the rats and footprints are located are the same, 15 to 7 million years. After that, I was sent many prints of human feet from Italy, Bulgaria and other areas. However, this is a subject for the next very interesting film. Thus, the rats did not exist by themselves. If there were motor vehicles, cars, cross-country vehicles, there should have been garages for them. In the previous film, we showed that there were such garages. If there were roads, there should have been road coatings. In the previous film, we showed that such coatings were. Fragments of improved ground and asphalt coatings have been found. If there were water and mud, then there should have been drainage systems. We said that ancient drainage systems were discovered near the stone roads. If there were cars, then there must have been creatures that controlled them. We really met footprints of people or other intelligent beings in different places near the rats. I think, if researchers carefully study these rats, then they will find much more such traces.